गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर विक्रांत सुधाकर पाड़ेकर, आई एम वर्किंग एज अ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज जवाहर पालघर। वेलकम इन द सीरीज ऑफ फोटो केमिस्ट्री। दिस इज अ सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन द फोटो केमिस्ट्री। इन द अर्लियर लेक्चर वी हैव सीन इंट्रोडक्टरी कंसेप्ट्स रिलेटेड विद द फोटो केमिस्ट्री एंड वी हैव कम टू नो दैट in photochemistry the organic reactions are brought about by light radiation of suitable wavelength, that is in the UV region from 200 to 300 nanometer, in which whenever this particular light is bombarded on the molecule, the electrons present in the molecules, they are getting excited to higher energy states, and during which their electron spins might change. We will revise some of the concepts what we have seen in the earlier session. We have seen the electronic excitations may be of singlet state or may be of triplet state. Let us see what are these states. As we have know, whatever the electron present in the ground state, that electron may be, let us say, from sigma, pi or n. So in singlet state, what happens? The electrons once get excited from bonding orbital to non-bonding orbitals, that is anti-bonding orbitals. So what happens in that case? In the singlet state, whatever the spins of these two electrons, they remains paired. As we know that in the ground state, the electrons are always paired. One electron with parallel spin while another electron with anti-parallel spin. So in singlet state also, these electrons remain in the paired form, but one electron is present in the bonding orbital, another is present in the anti-bonding orbital. So such a state is called as a singlet state. So this is a singlet excited state, S1. While in case of the triplet state, the spins of the electrons get changed. That is, both the electrons are having same spin, okay? So that is being called as a triplet state. So you can understood what is mean by singlet state and triplet state. It basically depends upon the spin direction of the electrons in the ground state and excited state. As we know that a singlet state, a molecule in which electron spins remains paired, that particular state is called as a singlet state. This is the case. Here we can see paired. While in triplet state, the two unpaired electrons have same spin. These two electrons in the triplet state will have same spin. In that case, we can say that particular electronic state is triplet state. Regarding the spin multiplicity, why it is called as a singlet state? As we know that it is directly related with the spin of electron. As we know that whenever the electrons are paired, they are having the spin plus half and minus half. Okay, so as in the singlet state, the spins are plus half, minus half. That's why plus half, minus half equal to zero. So how to calculate the spin multiplicity? By formula 2s plus 1. So as the value of s is 0, so if you put it, the spin multiplicity will come 1, and this particular state is called as a singlet state. So singlet state can be represented as, if the electron is in the ground state, that particular state is called as a S0. If the electron is excited in the first excited state, that is called as a S1. If it is excited in the second excited state, singlet excited state, it is called as a S2, and so on. So remember, S stand for singlet state. While in case of the triplet state, as we know that they are having unpaired spins. So what is the spin for first electron? Half plus half. For another second electron, that is also half. So half plus half equal to 1. So if you put one value of this in the formula 2s plus 1, this particular spin multiplicity will come 3. So that particular state will be called as a triplet state. So whenever the electron present in the triplet state, in the ground state, that will be called as a T0. In the first state, that is called as a T1. In the second state, it will be called as a second triplet excited state. Then we have also seen what are allowed transition and what are forbidden transitions. Allowed transitions are those transitions which are taking place in the same state, electronic state, that is from S0 to S1. This is allowed transition. They are taking place in the same state. T0 to T1, triplet ground state to triplet excited. These transitions are called as a allowed transitions. Why? What are forbidden transitions? Forbidden means they are not allowed. That is singlet to triplet or triplet to singlet. These particular transitions are called as a forbidden transitions. So I think this particular introduct part you might have gone through in the earlier session. So let us see the concept of photosensitization. What is mean by photosensitization? When an excited molecule in the singlet state or triplet state can transfer its energy to another molecule in the environment, this process is called as a photosensitization. As we know that in the photochemical reaction, whatever the molecule present in the ground state, if it receives energy, that is h nu equal to 1 photon, it get excited. Okay, so once it goes to the excited state, as we know that excited state is as per the energy, it is a high energy state. So it is being unstable also, it does not remain in for longer time at excited state. Once it get excited, it very fastly come to the lower energy level or ground state. So when it come from excited state to ground state, it emits energy, or that we can say radiation. So this particular process is called as a photosensitization, that is transfer of energy to another molecule. So once it comes to the ground state, it will emit that particular energy to another molecule. So that again will get excited. So this particular process is called as a photosensitization. So let us see. In excited molecule, whatever the excited molecule is called as a donor, while the another molecule is called as a acceptor. Okay, there are two species. One is donor, one which is being excited, and while another one which accepts that particular energy is called as a acceptor. So in the process of donor molecule drops to S0. Suppose the molecule is in the S1 state, that is singlet excited state, it comes to the ground state S0, while another that particular molecule is called as a photosensitizer. So donor molecule is called as a photosensitizer. Most of this process involves triplet state of the donor and acceptor, hence terms as a triplet energy state. So as we know that triplet state is having lower energy as compared to the singlet state. So this particular process occurs in the triplet state. So this particular it is also called as a triplet energy transfer. Let us see in case of the schematic representation. So as we know that the molecule which is being excited is called as a donor. So donor molecule receives energy, it goes to the excited state, that is this D1 star. So this particular molecule undergo the inter-system crossing, that is from one state into another state, that is first state into third state, that is called as a triplet excited state. Means donor molecule present in the singlet state transfers its energy and get converted into triplet excited state. Okay, three stand for triplet, one stand for singlet. So once this particular molecule get excited into a triplet excited state, it gives its energy to acceptor molecule. That acceptor molecule is called as a. So that particular molecule will get excited now, and this is a process called as a photosensitization. Very simple concept. Once molecule get energy, get excited, comes to the ground state, get its excess energy into another molecule, that again get excited. So this is a simple phenomenon. So basically, if you see what are the common examples of photosensitizer molecule, which acts as a donor. So donor molecule are called as a photosensitizer. Remember, donor molecules are called as a photosensitizer. What are these molecules? Benzophenone, acetophenone, naphthalene. So these are the examples of photosensitizers molecule. Now we are going to see a very important concept in this particular topic that is being called as a Jablonski diagram. So this particular diagram is very important. So this diagram gives us idea about various excitations and de-excitation process which are taking place in a molecule with the help of schematic representation. I will repeat, Jablonski diagram explain various excitations and de-excitations whatever are taking place in a molecule. So this particular diagram gives us qualitative summary. It is just give the qualitative summary of various electronic excitations taking place in the molecule. What are the energy levels S0, S1, S2 are shown with the horizontal lines, black lines, with the energy increasing. So as we know that ground state having lower energy, singlet excited state is having higher energy with the help of vertical axis. So and this particular axis you will find the energy. So before we go into the Jablonski diagram, let us understand for a few concepts. S0 represent singlet ground state. 0 means ground state. S1 first excited singlet state. S2 second excited singlet state. S2 stand for second. T stand for what? Triplet. So 1 stand for first, so it is a first excited triplet state. T2 second excited triplet state. ISC, that is inter system crossing. Inter system crossing means what? Singlet into triplet. So this is being, these are the terms which are very useful in order to understand this Jablonski diagram. As we know that what are the things takes place, let us say this electrons present in the ground state, it get excited. So what will happen? Once it go to the excited state, it can again come back to ground state, okay, by means of a different process. Here spins are remains same. This is paired, this is unpaired. The electron spin get reverse. So this will you find in the triplet state and this will you find in the singlet state, right? So this is the thing we will remember right now. So this is a Jablonski diagram, okay? This is a schematic representation. Understand this particular diagram, very simple diagram, although it looks very different. So in Jablonski diagram, as I already told you, there is a vertical axis, there is a energy is being plotted, and horizontal lines, what are there? These are the energy state, that is S0 ground state, S1 singlet excited state, first, S2 singlet excited state, second. Okay. So in this particular diagram, you will observe different processes A, B, then C, D, E, F, okay. So these are the different state we will understand. So as we have understood that this particular Jablonski diagram is helps to understand various energy levels. So in this particular process, let us say process A, B up to S. In this particular process, once the electron get excited, you will observe various excitations and de-excitations. So these excitations and de-excitations may be, let us say, radiative or non-radiative. Radiative means where emission of energy is being expected, or non-radiative where energy of, there will not be any emission of energy. So in this particular process, you will observe various excitations, electronic excitation, then electronic relaxation, that is vibrational relaxations, then phosphorescence, fluorescence, fluorescence and phosphorescence, these are both radiative phenomena, and then inter-system crossing. So these are the different things you will observe in this particular diagram. So remember, these are the processes. We will see one by one in the next slides. Let us see first step. First step is called as a process A. That is electronic excitation from S0 to S1 or S1 to S2. So this is the first step. So electron present in the ground state, it will receive a light energy. So what will happen? It will get excited to S1, that is singlet, first excited state. So this particular excitation is called as a electronic excitation. So if it receives excess of energy, it will get excited again from S1 to S2. So this process is called as a electronic excitation from S0 to S1 or S1 to S2. So this is a simple process and it takes place very fast. Once the molecule excited, it will be recorded in the time around 10 raised to minus 13 seconds. It is a very fast process. So remember, first process is electronic excitation. Then let us see next process, that is B. Okay, so this particular process B is directly related with the subdivided vibrational energy level. Every energy, electronic energy level, that is let us say S1, S0, S2, they are having sub vibrational energy levels. So whatever the molecule in higher vibrational level S1 state lose its energy by collision and come to ground vibrational state. Here you can see B in the same state only. So this is a B, this is a S2 from higher vibrational. These horizontal lines are sub energy levels, vibrational energy levels. Here you can see. So this you will observe that it will come to its lower vibrational energy level. So this is a very simple step. It lose energy in that case due to the collision. Then the second process, that is C, internal conversion. So what is this internal conversion? This is a very simple process, internal conversion from S2 to S1 or S1 to S0. So S1 to S0, this is a C process. So molecule can lose further energy by collision and come to ground state. So this is a very simple process. First step, molecule get excited. Now in the process number C, it will come to again ground state by loss of heat. Remember this particular process, internal conversion. So molecule from S2 to S1 or S1 to S0 come to lower energy level. Then the next phenomena, fluorescence, very important phenomena, fluorescence. Here the molecule present in the S1 will come to the S0. So here you can observe, this is a line which is shown with the help of wedge shaped arrows. So fluorescence is a radiative emissions, a radiative process where vibrationally relaxed molecule in S1 state lose energy by emission of radiation of lower energy than that of absorbed light. So this radiative process from S1 to S0 is called as a fluorescence. In fluorescence, you will observe the molecule will come from S1 state into S0 state. So this particular process will continue up to molecules are exposed to light. Until and now you are exposing that particular molecule to light, this particular phenomena you will observe. In the fluorescence, you will experience emission of radiation. So remember this particular process, fluorescence, very important. Then the next process, E, inter-system crossing. So this is a transfer of electronic state from S1 to T1. So this is T1, this is from singlet. See every vibrational state. So this is a, this particular line you can observe, this is a lower vibrational level of S1 and this is a higher vibrational level. As we know that the triplet state is having lower energy as compared to the singlet state. So when vibrational level of S1 state have lower energy as that of T1 state, in such case crossover takes place with loss or gain of energy. So inter-system crossing is just like you have to remember, it is a conversion from singlet excited state to triplet excited state. Although we have said that this particular state is forbidden, but it is not impossible. It can take place only when you have the same energy level. Okay, so this is being takes place. So this particular thing you have to remember here with the red color. Then the next phenomena, phosphorescence. Now our molecule is in the triplet state. So once from triplet state it comes to the ground state. So molecule in T1 state may come to the H0 by emission of radiation, which is called as a phosphorescence. So this is again a radiative process where emission of energy will take place. So this particular phosphorescence takes place even after you remove the source. You have to understand what is the difference between fluorescence and phosphorescence. Phosphorescence process continues even after you remove the light. So it takes place from T1 to H0. Remember, this is the emission of radiation. So this particular thing you have to remember. Now the process number R, the molecule present in the triplet state, this is a process what you have to remember. Okay, so what is this process? Photochemical reaction, process R. Here is the where you will observe the actual photochemical reaction will take place, and that particular energy present over here is sufficient to break the bonds. Okay, so this is a very simple state. T1 state you will observe the in the R state the actual photochemical reaction will take place, and the molecule will result in the breaking of the bond, and as a result of breaking of the bond the reactants get converted into product. So let us see what is S. Already we have seen the first part only in the this particular lecture. What is this process S? So S nothing but it is a photosensitization, T1 to S0. So T1 state, it transfer its energy to another molecule that is being called as a acceptor, that is from donor to acceptor, which is being getting excited. So remember this particular phenomena, that is what is S. S stand for photosensitization. I hope so you have understood the various different processes which are takes place with the help of Jablonski diagram. Whatever the all the processes what we have seen, it does not takes place every time. In some of the cases only you will observe. So go through this all the processes. I hope so you will understood. This is a very 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 important topic as per point of view of examination. So go through the concepts. Hope so you will understand. Thank you very much.